Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this
wait,
Patrick, this one's for you. I know on the live streams we've been kind of hounding you, perhaps harassing you about zooming in.
So I can see all my purchases.
Make that a little bigger.
So you can see how many purchases.
Both are really small.
Which one? This?
Both.
All right. What about
there? There we go. Whoa, yeah, that's good.
If I open up Dax Studio,
it's really small,
but you can use this query. Okay. All right. Okay. Adam, just hang on 1 second. Yeah.
So, can you zoom in? Does your zoom it work? Does zoom it work?
Yeah, my zoom it works.
Oh, it works today. Yay. I'm getting a little older and, you know, I got the glasses, everything, and your small text is driving me nuts. And so what I wanted to do in this video is just help you, Patrick, to help me help this guy. So I'm going to walk through a couple things that'll just help you bump things up so I can see it. Now, if you're watching this video also, these are things that'll help you if you're presenting Power BI in like a business setting, or if you're presenting at a conference or something. Remember those days? Those were nice. All right, let's get into this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. By the way, Patrick, you can hit that subscribe button too. All right, Patrick, I just want to help you out with a couple things that will just help you to help me, like I said. So we're going to go through a couple items. Some of these I know you know, but I just want to reinforce it to make sure that you're continuing to zoom in on things and just help everybody out. So enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. A lot of people ask, like, what do we do? Like when we're presenting on the live streams or conferences, how did you zoom in on that item or do all those wacky things? Zoomit can be used to help you out with a lot of things. So Zoomit itself is a free download from sysinternals.com, a Microsoft hosted tool, and it's been around for a long time. You can just go ahead and install it, and the default key for that is Control-1. So you can hit Control-1. Look at this, Patrick. This is amazing. I'm zoomed in. I can use my scroll button to go in really close. I can pull back. And what I can do is if I click, I get a little indicator here. I'm going to hold Control down and then I'm going to drag, which gives me a square. If I don't hold any key down, I can just, you know, scribble all over the place. And if I hold Control Shift, I can do arrows, lots of arrows to indicate where the issue is. That's always helpful. And I can hit the E key on the keyboard to erase the items. Control-1, come back out. That is amazing. I can also do Control-4, which lets me do a live interaction. So I can actually work with items zoomed in, which is great. And Control-4 to come back out. That was an easy one. Patrick, I know you've been using Zoomit for a long time. And I say using it, meaning it's installed. Sometimes we gotta remind you to zoom in, right? So be more gracious with your Zoomit usage. That is my suggestion. Let's see what can actually be done inside of Power BI Desktop if we don't want to install something like Zoomit or other tools like Zoomit that can be used, including the Windows magnifier. One thing that is available here that you may or may not be aware of, Patrick, I know you're for sure aware of this, is the actual Dax Formula Bar. So here we can see the default text in there. If I hold Control, I can scroll and make this bigger. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. I can read that. So I can Control, scroll wheel, go up and down, make it bigger so everyone can see. Everybody's happy. That's great. Unfortunately, I can't do that with the other windows or, you know, anything here that lets me zoom in the visual elements of the UI. If I go to the data tab, same thing. I can't Control or Control Shift. Power BI Desktop itself doesn't necessarily support that. In the model view, I can hold Control and use the mouse scroll to actually go in and out. Typically, let's see if the plus and minus do it too. They do not. Your mileage is going to vary. Some of the keyboard combinations will be different. Sometimes you can get away with like the plus and minus. Sometimes you can do the wheel mouse. Play around with those. But Patrick, you know, zoom in on those models too, because models like this, can't read them. Can't read them, especially on your big screen. So Zoomit and, you know, the Dax Formula Bar and the model view, they're very cool. One thing I'm going to do now is jump over to Dax Studio. Dax Studio is like perfection in this sense. This is what I want every tool to be able to do, including Power BI Desktop. Check this out. You can go external tools. If you have Dax Studio installed, you can just hit Dax Studio. I've already got it opened up. Prepare yourself. Control wheel scroll, you know, up or down on any pane inside of Dax Studio. Not the ribbon. For these items though, like the metadata, the query dialog, the output window, all of these I can individually control. So I'm holding down the control key, using the scroll wheel, going in and out. That is what I want on everything. I think we can all agree on that. But this is just a great way. If you just need to go in a little bit further, Dax Studio is your friend. You can do a lot there. All right, Patrick, the last thing I want to highlight, this one you may not know about. I actually just learned this not too long ago. I was watching something. I don't even remember what I was watching. I saw it and I'm like, what? I also called up Alex Powers and I'm like, did you know this? I will argue now that this is the best kept secret of Power BI all up. Let me show you. Let's go back into Power BI desktop. I'm going to go into transform data into Power Query. Everything else, control wheel scroll, doesn't do anything. You know, again, same as Power BI desktop. It's just, we just got nothing. I'm going to hold down control shift and use the scroll wheel. Nothing. Ugh, so frustrating. However, remember I said different keyboard combinations. I'm still holding down control shift. Let me hit the plus key on the keypad on my keyboard. What? And the minus goes out, the plus goes in. I can enlarge Power Query. How did I not know about this? Patrick, you didn't know about this either. We've been using Power BI for a long time. What is up with that? I'm actually, wait. I think I hear Patrick.
What the French toast?
Exactly. All right, Patrick, leave a comment down below and let me know, did you think this was bananas? For everyone else watching, do the same. Let me know. Also, let me know your other tricks for how you handle this or situations that you might be in where this is useful. I know it's useful for me. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.